Welcome to PC Analytics. Today, we're going to dig into the differences between two top budget coolers, the Thermalright Frost Commander 140 versus the DeepCool AK620. We've got our test bench right here, ready to put these coolers to the test and give you all the information you need to make the perfect choice for your setup. The AK620 and the Frost Commander are similar sized coolers with polished tops providing a sleek appearance. The AK620 features a darker look, 6 heat pipes and 2 120mm fans. While the Frost Commander has a gray look, 5 heat pipes, and a combination of a 120mm and 140mm fan. Both coolers offer easy installation, with the primary difference between them being their looks. However, the AK620 is known to have fan issues at the mid-RPMs, but we know you're here to see how these two budget coolers differ in terms of performance, so let's dig into it. We've tested both coolers over idle, high, and overclock temperatures, and have two sets of charts to show you, one that looks at performance normalized by percent speeds, and one that looks at performance normalized by sound. In our first set of charts normalized by percent speeds, we have temperatures on the left represented by the solid line, noise on the right represented by the dashed line, and percent speeds on the bottom. For this chart, lower is always better. At idle, the AK620 in red has similar performance as the Frost Commander in blue in terms of cooling performance. As we pump up the heat to 105 watts, we can see that the Frost Commander pulls ahead slightly in terms of cooling performance across all percent speeds. However, this comes at the cost of the Frost Commander being materially louder at the higher RPMs. As we move to overclock levels of 125 watts, we can see that the Frost Commander widens its lead slightly against the AK620. In our second set of charts, normalized by sound, we have temperatures on the left, noise on the bottom, with lower being better. At idle, both coolers perform similarly, and as we crank up the heat to 105 watts, we can see that both coolers perform similarly across most decimal levels. And when we push the CPU to 125 watts, we can see that this relationship holds. And if you're curious on how the Frost Commander stacks up against the golden benchmark, the NHD15, you should check out this video comparing these two coolers. Thanks for watching, and if you enjoyed this content and found it valuable, I invite you to support us by giving us a thumbs up or hitting that subscribe button.